Hey Courtney, it's Thursday here on C2C. I really enjoyed your video on Tuesday. I could tell that you really thought about it and you tried really hard to kind of look at some of the different contradictions. And I really agree with the article that you were talking about where if you tried to program all of the exceptions into a computer, it's an impossible task. What I wanted to talk about is a little bit of why there are contradictions. Why do we have all of these rules if pretty much every rule in society there are exceptions to? I'm guessing in every society that has structure, there will be exceptions for every single rule. Let's take something simple like I before E except after C. We have this rule to help young people with their writing. As I've grown up, people have added on to that phrase, so it's I before E except after C, and when they say A as in neighbor and way. And in weird words, like weird, if you take all of the words that have I and E next to each other, in the English language, more of them have E before I, regardless of if they came after C. So why do we have the rule that says I before E except after C if there's more exceptions to it than times that we actually follow it? Because we as humans like to put everything in neat little boxes with a little bow on top and say, these are the rules that we follow. It's easier to have a whole bunch of absolutes and then later make exceptions to them based on your own personal sense of morality and the ethics of whatever group that you're in. And in the case of linguistics, based on origins of the words and blah blah blah. Here's an example, not a perfect metaphor. Why do we have these rules? Because when you're teaching children the rules, then you have to give them specific rules to follow because they haven't seen enough of society and experienced enough social interactions to learn where the exceptions are. Now for me, I like to have a set of codes that I can follow because a lot of times in my head I go through a checklist. In engineering we call it a flow diagram, saying if this, then this, if not this, then this, and just going through it logically, you know, what am I allowed to do? And I try not to base a whole lot of stuff on my emotions because I know emotions can lead to wrong decisions more than they lead to right decisions. Contradictions are there because we want to have structured rules that say, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not commit adultery, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not lie, thou shalt not take the Lord's name in vain, etc., etc. You know the rest of them. If you go against the rules, there's a chance that you will be able to make the right decision based off of like your emotions and your know-how and your experiences, but there's also a chance that you'll mess up and you'll get it wrong and you don't have the excuse to fall back on, I was following the rules. Which is not a great excuse if the rules are telling you, you know, something like the Nazis, a lot of them were just following the rules and following orders. So it's not always a great excuse to fall back on. But as humans, we like having that kind of safety net saying this is what we're allowed to do. This is what we're supposed to be doing. And so those are society's rules, are the ones that we're supposed to be doing. And it's okay sometimes to deviate from them as long as we remember the core and we're making those other decisions based off of good moral and ethical grounds. I hope that you did well on your tests and good luck on your tests tomorrow. I will see you this weekend because I'm going to Katie's house. And then also your video on Saturday. I can't wait. I love you, Courtney. Good night.